What's up, everyone? Game Dad here, coming at you guys with a brand new collection video. And this is Cadison. She wanted to be in today's video. So today, what we're gonna do is take a look at all of the games that I currently have in my ColecoVision collection. So come with us as we check out the games. First on the list, we have Carnival, released by Coleco in 1982. And this game is essentially just like one big shooting gallery. So you have different objects that are moving back and forth on the screen, whether it be different like toy kind of things like ducks, rabbits, owls, or letters, numbers, various things. They all get you different points. Now, the whole time when you're playing the game, down at the bottom, you can see all these little notches. Those are slowly counting down. And the only way that you can get the score up is to keep shooting everything that's on the screen. And once you've shot everything, then there you go, you've won. Overall, I mean, the game is pretty fun. It's pretty simplistic. It has a very like Space Invaders kind of feel, but you know, without the impending doom of invasion. But overall, I mean, the game is a lot of fun, and I actually really enjoyed playing it. And much like all ColecoVision games, the coloring on this console is just awesome. It just was really far and above everything else. Up next is Donkey Kong, released by Coleco in 1982. And this game, I believe, was actually the pack-in for the console. And that is classic Donkey Kong Arcade, you know, that awesome Nintendo game that everybody loves to play. And you're going around playing as Mario in these. I believe he's actually called Jumpman, though. And you got to dodge barrels. Eventually, you got to dodge flame coming from the oil barrels. And, of course, then you get your different power-ups, like the hammer. That way you can take everything out, get your high score up. And at the top, I don't know if they've ever expressly said it was Princess Peach in the game, but obviously it looks like what would eventually become Princess Peach in later Nintendo titles. But you get up there, you rescue the damsel in distress, and then you get to move on to the next level where new challenges await, and you just get to have even more fun playing Donkey Kong Arcade. Up next, we have Ladybug, released by Coleco in 1982. Lots of games from 1982. And in this game, it's kind of like a Pac-Man clone, but there's extra different things you can get. And a big key difference that you'll notice are all of these like green bars with the blue dots in the center. Now, these are actually little paddles that you can flip, and it will change the path of the maze, which means it will change how the enemies get to you. And also, you actually get a countdown to when the enemies are released, as you can see by that green border kind of lighting up around the sides. So definitely a Pac-Man style game, but at the same time, it puts a really cool and unique twist on it, especially because the little critters that chase you are way faster than you, so you have to keep rearranging the maze as you go. So, I mean, I really liked it. This was a super fun game. Up next is Mousetrap, released by Coleco in 1982. And speaking of Pac-Man clones, this is like just a copy of a Pac-Man game. All they did was put some mice and cats in it. I mean, it kind of feels like along the same vibes as maybe the Matrix arcade, just with, you know, having the cat and stuff in it. But overall, I mean, this is a Pac-Man game. It's so plain to see, and so many different companies made a million different clones of the Pac-Man theme because it was just so popular at this time. Now, is this game bad? No. Is it great? No. I mean, it's exactly what you would expect, but with how many different clones there are, I mean, there's better ones to play than this, or, you know, you could always play the OG and just go with Pac-Man. Now, here we have Q-Bert, released by Parker Brothers in 1983, and this game is, again, exactly what you would expect. It is Q-Bert, but they actually added kind of like some 3D effects to it. I mean, the game has always had this kind of, not isometric view, but kind of pops out off the screen kind of view. And I gotta say, even though Q-Bert is a fun game, I absolutely hate the controls of this game. I really don't like how, in order to, you know, move down, you're actually moving a different direction. To move up, you're moving a different direction. Everything is just very odd, and it's hard to mentally get used to the way the controls work in this game. I mean, once you get it down, yeah, sure, it makes sense, and it's fairly easy to play the game. It's really straightforward. There's a lot going on the screen, but overall, I mean, the game is, it's okay, and there are better versions of Q-Bert. Up next, we have Smurf Rescue in Gargamel's Castle, released by Coleco in 1982. And fun fact about this game, it is actually the very first ColecoVision game that I ever played. And I did not grow up with this system or anything like that. I did not get one until I actually became a collector and started gathering games. But I was super impressed with this game. The audio was awesome. The animations were great. I couldn't believe it, especially with the era of consoles that this came from. But the colors were great. Animations were great. The controls were okay. They get a little weird sometimes, but overall, I mean, it was still a really fun game, and I enjoyed playing it. Up next, we have Turbo, released by Coleco in 1982, and I could not get this game to work properly. It loads up the menu screen so that you can select your difficulty level, and then it just doesn't do anything else. No matter what I tried, all I would get is this blue screen right here telling me to choose what skill level I wanted, and that was about it. Now, from what I understand, I believe it's a racing game, but that's about all I know about this game. Now, here we have Venture, released by Coleco in 1982, and think Adventure on the Atari 2600, which, by the way, is an awesome game. I actually did a Twitch playthrough of just beating Adventure first on easy and then on the hard mode. But this game, it takes that to a whole new level. It adds new screens with different rooms. It gives you all kinds of different weapons and stuff. As you can see right here, you know, I'm launching arrows out. And what you have to do is go around and collect every treasure that is in all of these different rooms. So the initial screen showed a bunch of question marks. Those are all the treasures that you have to collect. So it's kind of neat. You have like this overworld where you walk around, there's enemies there. Then you go into all these different rooms and you find different enemies. Like before, I don't know what the enemies were, but obviously right here, they're skeletons. And as you can see, there's one of the treasures collected. And overall, I mean, I thought this was a lot better than Adventure. It was really fun. And last up for this video is Zaxxon, released by Coleco in 1982. And this game is my personal favorite on the system out of all the games that I've played for Coleco. I thought this game was just amazing with the isometric view. Everything looks 3D with all the textures. It's just so cool to see something from 1982 have such depth. I mean, as you can see, it is a shooter. It's a shmup. And I mean, it's super fun, though. You can raise your elevation up and down to dodge things, fire at things. There's missiles being launched at you. There's obstacles in the way. And you just get to go all over this screen and just have a blast shooting everything in sight and just having a ton of fun doing it. I just still, even watching this footage again, I just can't believe that this was possible on a console from this time. Just everything about it is awesome. So there you have it, everyone. That is everything that is currently in my ColecoVision collection. Now, there aren't a lot of games in there right now, but I really do enjoy the ones that we have in the collection so far, especially Zaxxon. That is my personal favorite out of my collection, and I just have a blast playing that game anytime we turn it on. Now, if you know of any awesome ColecoVision games, please let me know down in the comments below. And while you're down there, please be sure to hit those like and subscribe buttons, as well as that little notification bell so you get an alert every time I got a new video coming out. Now, as always, I'm Game Dad. I thank you guys for watching, and I'll catch you later. Say bye, honey.